2019 Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer Review. The Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer will be the estate version in the Insignia Grand Sport, and promises greater practicality, equipment and value than the previous generation model, that was launched back 2009. To manage this step, Vauxhall has risen the size of its flagship estate. It's now more than an Audi A6 Avant, and stretched the space between front and back wheels by way of a colossal 92mm. The upshot is usually a spacious and roomy cabin teamed using a boot capacity as high as 1,665 litres using the rear seats folded, which can be enough to contend with rivals including the Mazda 6 Tourer, Ford Mondeo Estate and Skoda Superb Estate. Watch, we ran a Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer for a few months, find out how we got on. And yet, space race is merely half the battle in today's multifaceted large estate car class. The Skoda is superbly comfortable, the Mazda great driver and automobile and the Mondeo an all-round contender. Just what exactly else does the Vauxhall have up its sleeve to compete using the class leaders? Watch on, bags of exercise machines for your money. As always with Vauxhall, there's a huge selection of trim levels to pick from, through the base design spec as well as the top of the range elite NAF. All models come as standard with 17-inch alloy wheels, aircon, keyless entry and keyless ignition, a 7-inch infotainment screen, Bluetooth phone connectivity plus Apple CarPlay, Android Auto and Vauxhall OnStar assistance. There's more too, as Vauxhall tries to bring the Insignia Sports Tourer in line while using cutting-edge equipment entirely on rival cars. Optional equipment carries a head-up display, autonomous emergency braking, wireless charging and adaptive LED lighting. 6 available engines can be a weak link. We've no complaints concerning the sheer diversity from the engines offered. Clients are able from which to choose super-efficient 110-horsepower 1.6-litre diesels and 260-horsepower 2.0-litre turbocharged petrols whenever they wish. However, perhaps the all-new 1.5-litre petrol doesn't feel as punchy because the figures suggest, and offerings from rival manufacturers are crisper plus more enjoyable to push. Over around the diesel front, along with the 1.6-litre turbo D is talky but harsh at the very top end, and ultimately feels old hat. We've not driven it yet, but we reckon both the 0.0-litre turbo D will likely be worth the weight in gold over smaller displacement models. Big body, big boot, big practicality. Vauxhall couldn't exactly hike the dimensions on the Insignia Sports Tourer instead of make it any longer practical. Thankfully, the ideal boot capacity is continuing to grow by 135 litres to a single, 665 litres together with the rear seats folded down, and 560 litres using them in place. Space inside back seats comes to an end there while using best-in-class Skoda Superb Estate, providing ample legroom even while using front seats mismanagement issue. The higher level headroom can be impressive but bear in mind that the optional double panoramic sunroof reduces space dramatically. Comfort over cornering. The Insignia Sports Tourer is often a softly sprung family barge, also it makes no apologies for this. Try and drive it enthusiastically as you would a Ford Mondeo or perhaps a Mazda 6 Tourer and you also'll quickly have the body roll significantly when you move from bend to bend. This is not an automobile to be rushed. However, grip levels are high so when driven normally the important Vauxhall is usually a safe, comfortable and relaxing car to operate a vehicle. 3 petrol and 3 diesel engines being offered. 8-speed automatic gearbox available too. Currently no hybrid or electric version. Customers can choose between a choice of 3 petrol and 4 diesel engines, spanning coming from a super-efficient 110-horsepower 1.6-litre Equitec diesel to some turbocharged 260-horsepower 2.0-litre petrol with all-wheel drive as standard. Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer petrol engines. Diesel has long been the natural engine selection for the Insignia, yet a brand new 1.5-litre turbo petrol engine may be about to change this. Available in 2 different power outputs, customers employ a choice between a newbie 140-horsepower unit as well as a media 165-horsepower version, The former produces 250 Nm of torque, which is capable of accelerating from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 9.6 seconds, going on into a top speed of 129 miles per hour. Upgrade to your 165 horsepower power plant and there's a similar level of torque being offered, yet it's available over more in the rev range, peaking at 4,500 revolutions per minute as opposed towards the 140 horsepower unit's 4,100 revolutions per minute. This means it's capable to pull four in each gear, reaching 60 miles per hour from your standstill in 8.6 seconds and onto a high speed of 135 miles per hour. It's a nice refined unit most with the time, only be a touch raucous at the top in the rev range. Give the accelerator a good squeeze even just in 6th gear and there's useful surge of torque pushing your vehicle onwards. And yet, it doesn't quite feel as powerful as being the 165 horsepower suggests, and we'd question how well the engine would perform if your vehicle were rich in passengers. Take a try out if you're uncertain. The most effective petrol engine inside range may be the 260 horsepower 2.0 litre turbo 4x4. Capable in the 0 to 60 miles per hour sprint in 7.1 seconds along with a top speed of 152 miles per hour, it'll likely be the easiest Insignia sports tourer discounted, unless the rumored VXR model involves fruition. Torque is rated at 400 Nm. It certainly feels just as quick because 0 to 60 miles per hour time suggests, but those after the sporty drive will likely be disappointed. The engine sound is dull as well as the response is muted. We battle to see who buy this engine, so take into account the potential for poor residual values because of this. Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer Diesel Engines. Diesel power comes inside the shape of the 1.6-litre turbo D-Quatec or 2.0-litre turbo D engine. The former is needed on an assortment of other Vauxhall models and is particularly available in two states of tune. The lowest that produces 110 horsepower and 300 Nm of torque, giving a 0 to 60 miles per hour duration of 10.9 seconds along with a top speed of 127 miles per hour, move up towards the 136 horsepower version and also you get an extra 20 Nm of torque that is enough to take 0 to 60 miles per hour to 9.9 seconds, 10.2 to the auto. Top speed is 131 miles per hour with the manual version and 126 miles per hour to the auto. This is expected to get the biggest selling engine, while using glut of torque it generates useful for everyday driving. However, it will become coarse and flat after 3000 revolutions per minute, meaning there's little reason to keep onto the gears. It's also quite apparent that 6th gear is firmly meant for motorway use, as being the car struggles to provide any meaningful pull below 70 miles per hour on this gear. Rounding from the diesel engine options would be the 170 horsepower 2.0 litre turbo D, developing 400 Nm of torque and capable with the 0 to 60 miles per hour sprint in 8.4 seconds, 8.6 for your auto. Top speed is rated at 139 miles per hour for that 6-speed manual and 137 miles per hour for the Torto. We've not driven this engine yet, but reckon its blend of effortless pulling power and strong fuel economy could allow it to be the motor to own. Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer Gearbox Options. A 6-speed manual gearbox is standard fit on all engines except the 170 horsepower 2.0-litre diesel along with the 260 horsepower 2.0-litre petrol. Instead, they support an 8-speed automatic transmission only, which can be also available being a cost option around the 136 horsepower 1.6 litre diesel. The manual is light and straightforward to use, but feels soft and sludgy when switching between ratios. It's nowhere close to as precise because manual transmission inside a Mazda 6 wagon or Ford Mondeo Estate, example. We only a brief go from the 8-speed automatic, but tend to report it shifts gears smoothly and responds to down changes with reasonable speed. There's no paddles around the wheel, only the central selector. Focus on comfort instead of sporty handling. Lighter curb weight means more responsive drive. Plenty of grip, but plenty of body roll. Vauxhall knows its Insignia sports tourer usage exceptionally well, and realizes that designing a good, sporty large estate is just regarding the best way to scare every last one of which off. Hence why the 2019 Insignia sports tourer is firmly focused towards soft, supple riding comfort no matter what spec you have it in. However, despite the vehicle's increased size, it's lost approximately 200 kilograms over its predecessor, meaning it can do feeling lighter on its feet and even more willing to turn into a bend, even as we found out after we ran one for a few months. Drive around for a slow to medium pace and it also flows nicely from corner to corner, which has a slow but well-judged steering feel and adequate body control. Yet, push through to higher speeds as well as the Insignia sports tourer sets out to falter. Body roll, your body shell's lateral movement about the chassis, increases substantially the quicker you're going, or during emergency maneuvers, and although outright grip levels are high, it doesn't feel anywhere close to as crisp drive an automobile as a Mazda 6, or possibly a Skoda Superb for example. Safe and competent within the corners, but Vauxhall's big estate is lacking in driver enjoyment. Despite the vehicle's size, it's not hugely hard to park or devote tight spaces. There's decent visibility on all corners on the car width, even if your blind spots are bigger than on your average family estate. Disappointingly, parking sensors are merely standard on higher spec cars, otherwise being available as being a cost option. Functional interior isn't particularly stylish. All buttons and dials are really simple to watch and utilize, however. Ergonomics spoiled by significant blind spots. Sit behind the wheel in the Vauxhall Insignia sports tourer and also you immediately feel that this cabin may be geared up on the driver. The seat and tire carry excellent adjustment, even though the sat-nav screen is angled usefully inside direction from the driver. Dead ahead may be the clear, but slightly drab-looking dials on lower spec models, improving with a snazzy 8.0-inch digital display on elite nav versions. The leader is chunky but visually attractive, and doesn't impede around the driver's view with the dials. Cheap-feeling indicator stalks spoil the Ascent's quality, however, just like the odd items of hard plastics scattered throughout the cabin. And while most from the buttons and switches happen to be upgraded above the previous generation model, there's still some which sense that they've been fished out from the Vauxhall parts bin. The tacky plastic handbrake switch is really a prime example. The central infotainment screen, while helpfully angled for the driver, sits with excessive upward slant and is particularly too far away through the driver. A handily placed ridge below the screen with the user to relax their wrist on can make up with this, though. All-round visibility is reasonable for an automobile in this class. In addition to the optional head-up display will be worth specing if you're able to stretch with it, offering clear facts about vehicle data, navigation and multimedia. The Insignia sports tourer function is for to supply excellent ride comfort and superb cruising manners, and, on that front, Vauxhall's engineers have succeeded. Whether you're traveling over pockmarked urban roads or badly surfaced motorways, Vauxhall's big estate is impressively smooth and refined. Ride quality obviously deteriorates with larger alloy wheels, but within the standard 17-inch rims the Insignia sports tourer absorbs bumps and potholes with aplomb. The only time it comes undone happens when driven over sharp, repeated bumps, because the soft suspension struggles to react for the undulations with time. Up front and from the back, the seats are broad and comfy, with an abundance of support all round. There's tons of space, too, meaning rear seat passengers will surely stretch out on long journeys. Road noise could possibly be improved, even for the smaller 17-inch alloys, at speeds above 50 miles per hour, and is really a noticeable blot within the copybook of your otherwise refined package. Smooth, relaxed ride quality. Plenty of adjustment in driving position. Excellent numbers of space all round. The Insignia sports tourer was created for to deliver excellent ride comfort and superb cruising manners, and, on that front, Vauxhall's engineers have succeeded. Whether you're traveling over pockmarked urban roads or badly surfaced motorways, Vauxhall's big estate is impressively smooth and refined. Ride quality obviously deteriorates with larger alloy wheels, but around the standard 17-inch rims the Insignia Sports Tourer absorbs bumps and potholes with aplomb. Watch, we took our Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer by using an epic drive, observe how comfortable it absolutely was here. The only time it comes undone is the place where driven over sharp, repeated bumps, since the soft suspension struggles to react on the undulation soon enough. Up front and within the back, the seats are broad and comfy, with a lot of support all round. There's tons of space, too, meaning rear seat passengers will surely stretch out on long journeys. Road noise could possibly be improved, even around the smaller 17-inch alloys, at speeds above 50 miles per hour, and is usually a noticeable blot about the copybook associated with an otherwise refined package. 5 trim levels to pick from. Sporty 3 the favorite. Excellent variety of standard kit on all versions. Vauxhall offers 5 main trim levels with all the Insignia Sports Tourer, starting together with the base spec design and rising to top of the range elite NAF. Design and street tend to be available while using NAF suffix, which adds sat-nav, with fully integrated European mapping, as well as an 8.0-inch color infotainment screen. Watch, we ran an Insignia Sports Tourer for 6 months, see that which you thought with the equipment being offered here. Standard Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer equipment. Kicking from the range would be the base spec design trim. This includes R4.0 IntelliLink stereo audio with DAB radio and Bluetooth phone connectivity. 7.0-inch color touchscreen with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Vauxhall OnStar with 4G Wi-Fi hotspot. Aircon. Automatic headlights, keyless entry and keyless ignition. Leather tire. Autonomous emergency braking, lane departure warning with lane assist. 17-inch alloy wheels. Moving approximately street trim adds a little extra kit and sporty styling touches to your Insignia Sports Tourer, including front fog lights, dark-tinted rear windows, rain-sensitive windscreen wipers, sports front seats and sports pedals, dual-zone climate control, twin rear USB sockets, auto-dimming rear-view mirror. 3VX line NAF brings a sporty, more aggressive look on the car, adding no-cost choice of 18-inch alloy wheels, excluding 1.6 diesel models. VXR styling pack, including sports-style back and front bumpers, side sills and visible exhaust tailpipe. Heated, flat-bottom, leather-covered VX line leader. Dark fabric headlining. 4.2-inch dashboard color information display. For those after more equipment, Techline NAF enhances design spec together with the addition of rain-sensitive windscreen wipers, front and rear parking sensors, dual-zone electronic climate control, twin rear USB sockets, auto-dimming rear-view mirror, 4.2-inch dashboard color information display, driver's seat tilt and lumbar adjustment, front passenger seat height adjustment. Top spec elite NAF is really as plush because Insignia Sports Tourer gets, and, along with Techline NAF trim, includes adaptive IntelliLux LED matrix headlights, dark tinted rear windows, leather seats facings, heated front seats and outer rear seats. 8.0-inch dashboard color information display. Bose Premium Audio System, 260 horsepower turbo 4x4 models only. Vauxhall Insignia Sports Tourer optional equipment. Much with the Insignia Sports Tourer's optional kit comes within the form of fancy tech created to make the motorists and passengers life easier plus more comfortable. FlexRide is Vauxhall's tackle different switchable drive modes, and includes adaptive suspension of variety of road conditions. Driving assistance pack 2 on all trims besides design, design NAF, and features adaptive cruise control which, on automatic models, will even work in congested zones, able to coming with a complete stop then setting off again together with the car in front. Driving Assistance Pack 4 is just available on NAF models, and includes automatic parking, blind spot monitoring, a rear view camera and rear cross traffic alert. A head-up display may also be specced on NAF models in conjunction together with the 8.0-inch dashboard information display. A number of leather seat trims are conveniently obtainable, as is usually a Bose premium sound system and wireless phone charger for mobile phone devices. Winter Pack 1, 2, 3 and 4 add assortment of heating elements, including heated front seats, leather and windscreen, determined by whether leather seat trim plus the VXR interior pack has become specced. A towing pack, flex organizer pack, including a boot storage net and inserts on rails to help keep luggage in position, power tailgate and panoramic glass sunroof can be purchased, just beware that this latter compromises headroom and side rear. Also on offer is often a wide variety of metallic paint and alloy wheels, including lava red, abalone white and emerald green with the former. Expected 5-star Euro NCAP crash rating. Wide array of standard safety kit fitted as standard. 3 ISOFIX points in hole, located across rear seats. As well as boasting 6 airbags, ABS and ESP, the Insignia Sports Tourer also comes standard with advanced safety kit like autonomous emergency braking with forward collision warning, lane departure warning with lane assist and following distance indicator, displays the quantity of seconds that you are traveling behind the vehicle in front. Optional safety equipment includes adaptive cruise control with stop and go function, effective at bringing the car to some halt in traffic, front parking sensors, as well because the standard rear ones, automatic parking. Traffic sign recognition and blind spot monitoring. Other safety devices, for instance an energy absorbing steering column, side impact protection beams and front and back deformation zones may also be included as standard. If you frequently reverse from tight spaces or onto a fast-paced main road, then this optional rear view camera and rear cross traffic alert is exceptionally useful. The latter gives an audible warning should a motor vehicle be approaching the car the reversing out of and parking space or driveway. As for your actual physical safety with the car and the accident, the first generation Insignia scored the total 5 stars to use pre-2009 Euro NCAP crash test, and there's pointless to believe the 2019 Sports Tourer model should get anything lower than maximum marks. Large boot, and not quite as big as some rivals. Bags of space in the front and back seats. Plenty of storage dotted throughout the cabin. Much has become made with the Insignia Sports Tourer's boot size, but whichever way you square it, total luggage capacity lags behind many of its rivals. Measuring up at 560 litres with all the rear seats in position and 1,665 litres with these folded down, this lags significantly behind the Skoda Superb at 661,950 litres as well as the Volkswagen Passat at 650 and 1,780 litres. Watch, see how much we will gram into your boot in our Insignia Sports Tourer. Aside because of this the Insignia Sports Tourer gains advantage from ample rear leg and headroom, aforementioned is noticeably reduced with the optional panoramic sunroof, however. The former, especially, really allows rear seat passengers to stretch their legs out providing the top seat passenger hasn't got the seat positioned much back. Other benefits include armloads of storage space SP watch through the entire cabin, including capacious door bins and cup holders effective at swallowing just about the largest of drinks bottles. There's fashionable generously sized glove box and armrest storage area, helpful for hiding valuables from sight. Those with children will discover the 3 rear ISOFIX points incredibly useful, especially since the 3, like the middle one, appear wide enough to support a full-size child seat.